So I'm here with my Canon boys, and I'm actually shooting this video right now on the new G7X Mark III that we've seen pictures of for the last year. It's finally here and it comes in silver. I'm using the little bracket that I've used before. It's a little Manfrotto bracket, and this is the solution if you want good audio. I'm actually using the Rode Video Micro plugged into the freaking G7X. Can you believe it? There's a mic input.
It's amazing.
Nobody does this. Sony doesn't do this. Panasonic doesn't do this. And up until now, nobody has had a compact solution with a mic input other than the RX0 from Sony. This camera can do live streaming straight to your phone. You can charge it over USB-C. This is really a vlogger's dream camera. And even for somebody who's not a vlogger, I'm able to shoot fully manual right now. I'm not shooting in an automatic mode. Got nice bokeh, it's a f1.8 aperture. And the stabilization looks good because it's got the what, 5-axis, 4-axis, whatever. The only thing that I wish this had was dual pixel autofocus, and that is because Canon is using an older Sony sensor that doesn't have phase detect on it. So that's why we're not able to get Canon dual pixel autofocus. Maybe in version 4 we'll get that, but at the rate Canon's doing this, we'll have to wait 3 years to get that, and that's fine. But we've got the G7 X3. This is a great option for any YouTuber who wants a compact solution with external audio. I'm shooting vertically right now, and the cool thing about the G7 X Mark III is it has an accelerometer built into it, so it's actually able to know that you're shooting vertically for Instagram, and it like formats it perfectly, so you don't have to deal with correcting it in post. It actually looks good. I'm shooting 4K right now. How's that rolling shutter look? It's not as bad as the EOS R, so that's good for sure. There's no crop, no crop in 4K, but we don't get 24 frames per second, only 30 frames per second in 4K. Not a huge deal. A lot of people don't even notice this. We do have the ability to shoot slow-mo though at 120 frames per second in 1080p. We actually get Canon color and Canon menus and a mic input, so this is better than Sony. Believe me, trust me. Boom, cut to the future when I'm editing this video and I'm in my backyard and I need to finish this video up. I'm really excited about the G7X Mark III. I have one on order from B&H and I will get one as soon as possible. Also, if you're in the market for a camera similar to the G7X Mark III but don't want to pay that hefty price tag, then I've made a playlist just for you. Inside that playlist is a bunch of reviews that I've made in the past about Canon cameras that are similar to the G7X but are at a cheaper price point now that they're a little bit older. Once again, I'm Dave Mays. This is Kinotika. See you next time.